Hi, I'm Margaret Martin at Mueller Guide. Thank you for tuning in. Today I am going to cover hypermobility spectrum disorder, and I have invited a very special client, Victoria, who we have determined is hypermobile, but we're going to go through determining that as we did a few weeks ago. So one of the reasons I asked Victoria here is that one of the first things when Victoria came to see me and wanted an exercise program to strengthen her bones was her hesitation towards exercise because of negative consequences in the past, and B, like many of my clients who are hypermobile, she ran into problems early on. Pain, discomfort, you know, with doing exercises. And so the importance of finding out, A, as clinicians, that somebody's hypermobile really allows you to take slower steps in working with somebody. And for individuals, if you test yourself and find out that you're hypermobile, there's a lot of other implications that are important. Now, both of those things will be covered in future blogs. Today, what I would like to cover is the way in which you go about testing for the hypermobility spectrum disorder. So one of the first ways is simply a questionnaire. So if you do not have the client with you, or you decide you don't have the time in your practice, you can at least have them complete a questionnaire. So five questions that have an 85% specificity and sensitivity mean it's pretty accurate, and it was tested in both internationally and in different languages. These five questions are as follows. So, can you now, Victoria, or could you ever place your hands flat on the floor without bending your knees?
Yes.
Okay. Can you now or could you ever bend your thumb to touch your forearm?
Yes.
Okay. As a child, did you amuse your friends by contorting your body into strange shapes, or could you do the splits?
I could do the splits.
Okay. Yes. As a child or teenager, did your shoulder or kneecap ever dislocate more than once?
No.
Okay. And do you consider yourself double-jointed?
I do.
Okay. So if an individual scores two or more out of the five questions, they have an 85% chance, really, of being hypermobile. Now, if you are fortunate enough to have them with you, or you can at home do these tests on yourself, we're going to run through the actual physical tests that allow you to be even more specific. So let's go through the five tests. These tests are scored for a total of 9 points. So the very first test, and I'm going to show you, I have a very little bit of hypermobility so that the audience can kind of see the difference between a relatively normal range of motion, is to have your forearm and hand in a straight line and to bring your little finger back. Okay, very good. And could you repeat that same thing on the other hand for me? So for every finger that, little finger, right, left, that Victoria is able to do at 90 degrees, that's 1 point. So 1 point for right, 1 point for left. Okay, the next one would be to bring your thumb down to your forearm. Okay. And could you repeat that on the other side as well? Okay, very good. Thank you. And so then you get 2 more points. Then it's the elbow. The ability to straighten the elbow past the horizon. And so I'm going to take my goniometer out. And so just measuring the distance from the inside of the arm down through and seeing how far she can go. And we're getting about minus 20 degrees, okay? And can you repeat that on the other side, please? So straight out and bring that elbow down. Okay, not quite as flexible here, but we're still about minus 15. Okay, very good. So again, you get 1 point for each side. The other one that's done double are the knees. Okay, so I'll have you lay down on your back, please. Thank you for lying down on your back, since you're not a chicken laying eggs. Thank you. And heels up, perfect. And then if you could bring the back of your knees down, perfect. And so her ability to bend backwards. All right. Just coming in at minus 10 degrees. Okay. The last test that is done, so that she would score 1 point for each knee. The last test that is done is the test where she would actually be standing straight and bringing her hands flat to the floor. So then the score is issued out of 9 points, but within the hypermobility spectrum disorder, just because you score 9 out of 9 doesn't mean that you're going to have more problems than somebody that scores 1 out of 9. There's a spectrum of other issues that you may face that is important for you to be aware of and for your clinician to be aware of as well. So please stay tuned for the other blogs where we'll discuss the implications for yoga, for exercise, and for just day-to-day life activities. Thank you for tuning in. I'm Margaret, Familiar Guide.